Hello guys, we are back with our next lecture. In this lecture, let us go through the phase shift keying, guys. So here from the name only, you will be directly saying that, okay, so here phase will be changed. So most of us will be sometime confused about this phase concept, right? Okay. So now I'll be explaining you what is the phase change clearly, guys. Okay. Yes. So first I'll be taking the example, then we'll be moving on to the thing, guys. Okay. Yes. So assume that our signal, our original data is 1 0 1 1 0. So I just took a random example. Okay, it is not matching, right? Okay, so you can just check this example once I'm done with this example, guys. Okay, yes. So now please concentrate for 2 minutes, guys. That's it. Okay, yes. So first let me divide this into different regions, guys. Guys, I'll be taking only a single cycle, guys, because when I try to take two cycles, it is really complex, guys, because the diagram will be in this way and it is really confusing to understand. Okay, yes. So basically, whenever the phase word comes, so whenever the phase is a constant, so assume them in this way, guys. Okay, so if a phase is a normal, there is no change in phase, so the wave will be continuing in this way, guys. Okay, yes, for every time you will be getting it at that point. Okay, sorry, here at that point. Okay, so exactly you will be having one crest and one trough, one crest, one trough, one crest, one trough. Okay, I've drawn it in the wrong way, so let me redraw it. Okay, so one crest, one trough. So here I'm giving the frequency as a 1, so that is the reason why I'm taking 1, guys. Okay, so crest, trough, crest, trough. So basically in this way it should look. So this is the normal one, right? Yes. So whenever we are discussing about a phase shift, you'll be just flipping it, guys. Okay, so let us try first off. Okay, let us take this example only directly. So okay, so here it is a 1, right? So let us continue in this way. Okay, so here there is a change, right? So here from 1 we came to 0. So let us change the phase. So I told you, so instead of going up, go down, guys. So drawing this is a bit confusing. Even I'll be missing some kind of things sometimes. So I think I missed something. Nothing, I didn't miss anything. Okay, yes. So this is one trough and one, this is one crest. So again we have 1. So again there is a phase change, right? So from 0 you came to 1. So again change it. So instead of going down, you will be going up. Okay, again here it is constant, so you can continue up only. Okay, again here it is opposite, so you need to go in the opposite direction. So instead of going up, you will be going down. So here you are just changing the phase, guys. That is the main thing. So I hope everyone got some basic idea, right? Guys, if you are confused with this, you cannot understand this, guys. So once, go back in the video and replay it again from the start where I have explained this, guys, please, because you should be clear with it, guys. Okay, yes. So now let us go through this example. So in this example, I have drawn 2 frequency cycles. So here I took the frequency as 2. So I did not understand at the first point that it will be too complex, but in book, unfortunately, I took f equal to 2, and it is a bit complex even for me to draw also, right? Yes. So initially it is a 1, then 0, then 1, then 0, then 1, 1 and 0. Okay, so please concentrate for 1 minute, guys. This is the last time you will be drawing this, so don't worry. So here it is a 1. So 1 means it will be going in the normal way. So it came until here. So here there is a change, right? Yes. So normally it should go up and come down, right? Hence here there is a change. It will go in the opposite direction. So it went down and came up. Okay. So it ended up here again. So again there is a change. So instead of going down, it will go up. Okay. So again it ended up here. So here again 0. So again from 1 it is a change. So again from here, instead of going up, you will be going down. So this changing of things is nothing but the phase, guys. You will be saying reciprocaling the phase. You are changing 180 degrees phase. Okay. Yes. So again, you ended up here. So again, there is a change. So instead of going down, you will be going up. You came here. Here, there is a no change. So happily, you will be continuing from here. Instead of, going up, you will be continuing up only because there is no change. Again, here, change. So again, instead of going up, you will be going down. So in this way, the phase change will occur, guys. So this is a bit tough to explain also for me also. So that is the reason why I have explained you with the 2 examples. So the first example I have drawn and the second example I have shown in the book. Okay. Yes. So phase shift keying, PSK, is a digital modulation technique in which the phases of the carrier signal is changed by varying the sine and cosine inputs at the particular time. Okay. So it is widely used in a wireless LAN, biometric, okay, and contactless operations, so Bluetooth communication, etc. So if you ask me, this is a widely used, guys. The phase shift keying is the most widely used thing. Okay, yes. So I hope everyone got some basic idea about this phase shift keying, right? Yes. So now we are done with the three different types, right? Frequency, amplitude, amplitude and phase. So now let us continue with one advanced method, that is nothing but advanced frequency shift keying, guys. Okay? Yes. So this is the exact method, we can say, sorry, this is the exact concept of frequency shift keying, but with a small change, guys. There is a small twist, you can say. Okay, yes. So that is the reason why it is called as an advanced one. So a frequency shift keying used in mainly wireless systems is minimum shift keying. So this advanced shift frequency shift keying is also called as minimum shift keying, guys. Okay, so the diagram will look in this way, guys. Okay, so the diagram might be a bit complex by observation, but once we understand the steps and once we understand the logic behind it, it will be a piece of cake for you guys. Okay, yes. So let us go through the steps, then I'll be explaining you the problem. Okay, yes. So let us start. So the first step is, okay, let us solve it step by step only, guys. Only then you'll be getting a clear idea. Okay, yes. So the data bits are represented into even and odd bits. Okay, yes. So first of all, you'll be having the data, guys. So assume that our data is 1 0 1 1 0 1 0. Okay, so once we got that data, what we want to send, you will be assigning some numbers. So those numbers are nothing but our normal numbers, like 1 2 3 4. So this is our first bit, this is our second bit, this is our third bit, this is our fourth bit, this is our fifth bit, this is our sixth bit, this is our seventh bit. So we indicated with 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 for 7 bits. Done? Yes. So the first step, first part is done. Okay, so write down the numbers to the input data, then based on that, draw even bit and odd bit signals. Okay, so most of us will be confused here, guys. So here they are saying that even signal, odd signal. So what is this even signal and odd signal? Okay, yes. So just give me a second, guys. I'll be back in a moment.